everyone. It's Eizen once again for more of Mega Man March Madness. We return back to Street Fighter X Mega Man. Mainly, because I've already, faced against all the eight, so now I know what all their weaknesses are. And let's see if there are different ways how I can defeat these bosses. Like, for example, maybe, I can kill Balrog before he gets the end. Or, if that's not the case, maybe a different way. So, of course, huge concentration here, because we are now at the part where things really start to get hectic. And by hectic, I mean very fast, that you could end up right next to Balrog, like that. And this time, even if he gets... there's an E-Tank there. Granted, I'm glad to know that you still survive even if you don't hit that bridge. But that doesn't mean I'm not angry that there was a possible E-Tank I could have gotten. That still makes me a bit upset. I'm not gonna lie. So with that, let's just continue onward. And just to let you know, I got multiple lives. And actually some updates that I should let you know about. I tried to do the whole farming for, E-Tanks things in some of the previous stages. Like, I figured, well, okay, if you can't, revisit the stages when you beat a boss, which I tried before going into Urien's stage, yeah, you can't do that. Ow. That was stupid. Ow. Ow. Just tank through it. Yeah, just tank through it. Oof. It's not gonna be worth it if I can't climb up here. So keep going. Almost there. Ow. Okay. Semi-hardest part done. Getting more health back, which is always a good thing. Why do I keep forgetting about that section? Oh. I still have more health. Always, always appreciate it. It turns out that if you've gotten an E-Tank from a previous stage, it doesn't respawn. So that would explain the whole, why... Ow. Don't want to die. Really don't want to die. Would have helped if I had, more health. Of course, I'm at the boss right now, which is, of course, Vega. And, of course, now that I know that E-Tanks are limited, this means trying to go against Vega with limited health. Yeah, limited health usage. Ow. And, of course, that means actually trying to understand an enemy's move. Is, of course, a terrible thing that I can do. So it seems like the lightning kick is his weakness, considering the rivalry between Chun-Li and Vega. I'm gonna try and do Buster only, because so far, range has proven to be my best weapon here. And, oh, I had no idea I could climb that fence, too. Ow. did. You know that? Just thought I'd let you know that, Vega. Ah. Well, I'm getting closer. I am getting closer. And what I notice is that the leaves themselves don't do damage, but they are bullet eaters, so... Okay. It seems a bit difficult, but I know I have full confidence in myself. But most importantly, if I don't do stupid things like that. Ow. Seriously, stay away from me, man. You bad juju. Ow. Ow. Seriously, stay the hell away from me. Ow. Okay, in all seriousness, that was really my own fault.
Huh, look where you're going, Eizen.
So, of course, as you all might have figured out, the main reason I'm doing this again is to prove that, yes, there are secret bosses here. And I learned there are actually two different secret bosses. Hopefully, if I do this right, I can show that off. Of course, that's the trick. Doing it right. Which of course means not getting hit by Vega! Okay, so I guess that's the main reason why you should... In case he's too close, you can just climb that and avoid taking damage from that. Now that I know that, let's see if we can do this more effectively. That's not using it more effectively! In fact, that's getting hit more often. I dodged that. You know I did. Ow. Okay, I really don't feel confident this time around. I mean, look at how much health I have compared to how much he has. Especially if he does that. Wonder how many lives do I have even? Three more. Of course, I want to get over to the next stage without wasting an E-Tank, but I fear that might even be possible. Great, I'm going! Oh, thank you. Yes, we did it. We got down Vega. I am so happy. Okay, so here's the deal. There's one boss you go against. I'm not going to say who it is, because if you know the Street Fighter series, you know what it is. If you got four perfects against bosses at any time after going against the final boss, M. Bison, that's when you meet the secret character boss. However, I didn't get that beforehand, and I was saving it till now. Why? Because if you got 4 perfects in boss rush mode here, that's when you go against Sagat before going against M. Bison. So, yes. Now that we know that, and I already saw a glowing M-Tank right there, so I'm going to have at least 5 E-Tanks going up here, so let's hope this means that I should have little to no trouble against this. I know I was able to despawn that thing a while ago, and I'm wondering if I'm able to do that again. So far, it seems like that's a no. Ow. Also, I should probably not take hits. Or I can just do that. There's always that. Okay, so that's the hardest part out of the way. Yay. Okay, so first off, let's restore health. I didn't really think there was anything that could determine that. So now the big question is remembering who I'm going against with what. Which, of course, now I know how it goes. Ryu's weapon is good against Chun-Li, which is good against Sea Viper, which is good against Dalsim, which is good against Blanca, which is good against Rose, which is good against Rolento, which is good against Urien, which is good against right back at Ryu. So, if I remember that mentality, I should be fine. Oh, jeez. So, yeah. Hopefully. Ah! Oh crap, I'm out of that. Damn it, now I have to actually try. But that's okay. I'm not that concerned. Why is that? Because, while it's true, you need a perfect in order for it to count. So long as you have full health, that's all that's necessary. Like that. It doesn't matter if you've taken damage from an enemy, so long as you finish the boss with full health. That's all that matters for having a perfect. So that's one down. So now it's just a matter of figuring out which of the other 7 is going to be the easier of them. So, which was this one? Oh, Dalsim. Yeah, I have full confidence I could be able to do this one, no problem. Hey, come on. Stop dodging. It took damage right at the end. But it still gave me the perfect beforehand, so that technically counts. Whew. So now I'm already halfway to my objective. Let's see, who was... Oh, Blanca. Okay, this one I'm gonna try and shoot for, but I'm actually not gonna be surprised if at the last minute I somehow take damage from him, because he is still a tricky one to go through. In fact, yeah, let's wait till after that. There we go. Okay, so yeah, it's not just about finding out which is the easier of them to perfect, but also... also about perfect timing. Dang it! Ah, I can't... can't even get mad at the game. That was my own stupidity there. Okay, so who am I going against next? Rolento! That, actually, it's easy for him to take damage to the shield, but I actually don't have confidence in getting a perfect on him, so just finishing him off right then and there. This time, let's not be an idiot and just destroy that before anything else. Sometimes this game, I tell you, sometimes with this game. Alright, next up, Rose. So now I'm doing Tropical Hazard. And actually, I experimented a bit with this one, because as you all know, when I just did it, I just basically made it as a drop-in ball, hope it hits. I actually learned that if you drop it and slide, it'll do the upward kick. And I believe the same thing happens while, if you're next to it and hold up, it kicks up, while holding down and fire does a straightforward kick, so. Actually, considering how that fight was going, it was probably for the best. So, if that's how Rose is gonna be, I think I'm gonna try and shoot for, I know I can't do it with Uri, and that's just a no-brainer. I'm actually gonna try it if I remember this slot correctly. It should be, that's the switch button. Chun-Li, because I have full confidence I could be able to do this, provided I don't do stupid things. Oof. And I'm actually surprised I still have yet to take a hit. So much for that. Yeah, let me wait until that happens. Oh, actually, yeah. Let's whittle her down first. And then try that. There we go. Okay, so that's 4 perfects in Boss Rush. Hopefully, this means that if I've done this correctly, I'm gonna still try and shoot for perfects, because why not? But if I've done this correctly, and I've beaten all the bosses, right? The next opponent I go against should be Sagat after this stage. Ooh. Yeah, concentrate. Concentrate, Eizen. Let's just focus on what we can do for now. Yeah, like so. Okay, sorry for the brief moment of pause there, but when your fights get as epic as that, I think it warrants a bit of a silent moment there. Not saying, just saying. Let's try taking on Sea Viper next. And again, much like with Vega, if I don't do stupid things, I'm gonna try the whole range being my ally here. But that's the problem with Sea Viper. Range could sometimes be her ally as well. oh dear. That only puts me. Oh, so I have to get this. I have to get to the next stage. Hopefully, this means I just go against Sagat right afterwards. I truly hope so. I would hate to come this far just to realize, oh, it's too late now. Ow. Dramatic tension! Woo! Okay, so now I have one more E-tank to spare before going into the next area. Hopefully, I can handle Sea Viper just fine. I'm gonna try Lightning Kick this time around. I actually have more health, so hopefully that means I handle this much better. Doing good so far. Ow. And somehow I still made it, with two energy tanks left. And I didn't have to use continue. Do I go against Scott now? Ooh. It's raining. Hopefully that means I go against Scott. Hey, Scott, old buddy, how you been? The original King of the Fighters. Tiger, tiger, tiger knee, tiger uppercut, tiger, tiger, tiger. I don't expect me to win this round. Besides, I've already proven that this is worth a reward. Continue from there. Woo! Now this is what it's all about. And I'm gonna try a gamble here. Sagat was always considered, Ryu was always considered Sagat's rival. I think that's his weakness? Seems like it, and that was a powerful tiger shot. I don't even care if I'm getting my ass kicked right now. With this boss fight, it's already as epic as it is. Ow. Yeah, I don't see myself winning this. Huh. This is gonna be tricky. Oh, I guess at the very least I should try other moves. Because you never know. That's a no. That's a no. No. Stop punching yourself! Stop punching yourself! But no, it doesn't look like the Aegis reflector is working. So, let's try a different move instead. Let's see. Minesweeper, Optic Laser, and Lightning Kick are the only ones remaining. And somehow I still doubt it's anything else but the Hadouken. Yeah, that's a no. Oh, that's a huge no. No, it has to be. Though I wonder, just out of curiosity's sake, I couldn't even tell. because I think it interrupted one of his moves. So let's try this again. I'm guessing that's really a no. Would help if you switch moves! Try non-charged Hadoukens, because it seems to be doing as much damage. Ow. Okay, yes, it can be done. It can be done. If you concentrate hard enough, beating Sagat is indeed possible. Not doing stupid stuff, which is exactly what I was doing. That's it. Let's keep going. There we go, and now, we jump straight into, hopefully this means I don't have to do both at the same time, because that would suck. Oof. Ow. Do I have to do both at the same time? Shit, I get the feeling I have to do both at the same time. Okay. Now this hard boss fight became even more harder. Oh, pray for me, everyone. How am I gonna get through this? Okay. Concentrate. You can do this, Eizen. Ow. Oh. That was kind of a low blow there, Bison. So now it's no longer a matter of can I defeat Sagat just to get to M. Bison, but now a matter of being able to defeat both without having too much problems. Actually, considering the amount of health I had at that point, I did not feel like risking that one there. Let's keep going with this. Yeah, we'll say no to that one and just jump right into... And by... Oh, he's on the other side. So, no really side advantage. You can just appear anywhere, and... Why did I do that? Okay, seriously! That is kind of cheap. I'm going to say that right here and now, and Bison. That is kind of cheap. That fight went well. My fireballs aren't really doing that much. Here, have a fruit! That's gonna help you feel better! No, it's not gonna help him feel better. Like, if anything, it's gonna tick him off even more. Well, Eizen, all that can be said after that is, welcome to Street Fighter Cross Mega Man. There really is nothing else that can be said about that. I really don't want to go against them, Bison, with this amount of health. See? That's playing fair. That was just... No, that's me playing stupid. Okay, once again, going up against Sagat. Okay, now I feel like, provided he doesn't do a cheap Psycho Crusher super, if he was to get me with anything... Oh! How'd I do that? Seriously, that was freaking awesome. Okay, now would be a good time to... Good time to use those... E-tanks. Actually, wasn't expecting to hit him that time. No. Don't! Gotcha that time, though. Ow. Ow. And I can't do that. So now I'm forced to do Buster only. That's okay. Ow. Hey, I did it! Yes! And I only needed to use one M-tank, or E-tank, something tank. Insert letter, number, tank, whatever. Woo! Oh! Now that was exhilarating. This was definitely worth it. I don't even care if I get the super special secret ending boss fight. Just the fact that I had to do both Sagat and M. Bison as one fight. Whew! That definitely gets your heart pumping there. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I don't know what else to say about that. Why am I talking like this? That's just exhilarating. I have no idea what I'm saying. The Street Fighter Cross Mega Man Team. Okay, seriously, drop the stupid accent. Oh man. Now, of course, if you're not that into Mega Man, you shouldn't follow my route. If you are that much of a hardcore Mega Man fan, oh yeah, this is definitely a good recommendation right there just for that. I'm sorry, I can't stop this emotion I'm having. It's such a good feeling I have. Oh, such a good feeling. Absolutely amazing. Woo! And of course, all the credits that go along through there. I'm telling you, the original makers of this fan-made Flash game, they were highly dedicated to this. And it shows. It definitely shows. Huh. Thank you for playing Street Fighter Cross Mega Man. And title screen. Oh, wait. So that's really it? Oh. Okay, so I guess it has to be done another way for the super special secret final boss. Well, again, if I have the opportunity and time to do so, then yes, I will gladly do that. Of course, for now, that's gonna be it. And whether I have the time or not, no matter what, next thing we're tackling is Megamari. So I hope to see you then. Take care, and I'll see you then. Okay, I actually flubbed up on that last bit. This has been Eizen for Street Fighter Cross Mega Man for Mega Man March Madness 2015 edition. Okay, seriously, why am I still talking? End this video already!